हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट मेजरमेंट ऑफ हाई वोल्टेजेस, स्फीयर गैप्स। जनरली द हाई वोल्टेजेस आर मेजर्ड यूजिंग द स्फीयर गैप्स। पीक वैल्यूज ऑफ वोल्टेजेस मे बी मेजर्ड फ्रॉम 2 किलोवाट टू अबाउट 2500 किलोवाट बाय मीन्स ऑफ स्फीयर्स। फिगर शोज द वर्टिकल अरेंजमेंट ऑफ स्फीयर गैप्स अरेंजमेंट। So here labels are given. First one is the insulator support, two is sphere shank, third one is operating gear and motor for charging gap distance. Here we can see the operating gear and motor for charging gap distance. Four is HV connection. Here we can see the HV connection for it is given to the upper sphere. P is the sparking point, so here you can see the P. Diameter of the sphere is capital D, so it is, we can see the capital D. Spacing is nothing but the distance between these two spheres. By adjusting the this distance, we can adjust the distance. A is height of P above the earth. Capital B is the radius of the clearance from external structures. Capital X is a high voltage lead should not pass through this plane within a distance B from P. So this is the arrangement of a sphere gap for vertical spheres. Now here we can see the sphere gap arrangement for horizontal setup. In a vertical arrangement, lower sphere is grounded for higher voltages, and in a horizontal setup, horizontally with both spheres connected to the source voltage, or one sphere is grounded for lower voltages, and all the dimensions we can see, diameter of the sphere, spacing, and all these things we can see in the figure. This is the real-time photograph of sphere gap arrangement. The arrangement is selected based on the relation between the peak voltage determined by spark over between the spheres and the reading of voltmeter on the primary or input side of the high voltage source. This relation should be within 3%. It is given by the IEC committee. So it is an international standard. Standard values of sphere diameter are 6.25, 12.5, 25, 50, 75, 100, 150, and 200 centimeter. These are the standard values for sphere diameter. The clearance around the sphere gaps. So there must be the clearance around the sphere gaps as per the guidelines given by the international committee. Here we can see the graph. This graph is for breakdown voltage characteristics of sphere gap. So we can see the as the gap distance is increases, if we go into this side, then gap distance is increases, the breakdown voltage is also increases. So this is the characteristics of the sphere gap arrangement. The effect of humidity is to increase the breakdown voltage of sphere gaps by up to 3%. So this is the effect of humidity in sphere gap measurement. Temperature and pressure, however, have a significant influence on breakdown voltage. Breakdown voltage under normal atmospheric conditions is Vs is equal to K into Vn, where K is a factor related to the relative air density delta. So this is the equation for relative air density. Small delta is equal to P upon 760 into 273 plus 20 upon 273 plus T. So this is the equation for relative air density. The relation between the relative air density and the correction factor K is given in this table. Under impulse voltages, the voltage at which there is a 50% breakdown probability is recognized as the breakdown level. Now, what are the factors that are influencing the spark or voltage of sphere gaps? So these are the nearby earthed objects, atmospheric conditions and humidity, irradiation and polarity, and rise time of voltage waveforms. So these are the factors that influence the measurement of sphere gaps. The limit of accuracy are dependent on the ratio of the spacing d to the sphere diameter d as follows. So if the spacing d is less than 0.5 into diameter d, then accuracy will be plus or minus 3%. And if the spacing between d is 0.75 into diameter is greater than spacing d is greater than 0.5 d, it means spacing is in between 0.75 into diameter to 0.5 into diameter, then accuracy will be plus or minus 5%. For accurate measurement purposes, gap distance is in excess of 0.75 d are not used.
Now, electrostatic voltmeter. One of the direct methods of measuring high voltages is by means of electrostatic voltmeters. For voltages above 10 kV, generally the attracted disc type electrostatic voltmeter is used. Here figure is given for attracted disc type electrostatic voltmeter. Here we can see two plates, right hand side plate and left hand side plate. Right hand side plate is connected with high voltage terminal, and left hand side plate is connected to ground. Here we can see this. When two parallel conducting plates, its cross sectional area A and spacing between these two plates is S, and charge is Q, and have a potential difference between these two plate is V, then the energy stored in this is given by W is equal to 1 by 2 CV square. It is well known equation. Now differentiate it to this equation, then we get dW is equal to 1 by 2 V square into DC, and it is equal to F into DS, where F is equal to force. Therefore, force F is equal to 1 by 2 V square into DC upon DS Newton. So this way we can get equation of force. Now we have to find out DC upon DS. We know that for the uniform field capacitance, C is equal to A into epsilon upon S. Now differentiate this equation, then we get DC upon DS is equal to minus A into epsilon upon S square. Now the value of DC upon DS, we have to put this value into above equation. Then we get F is equal to minus 1 by 2 into A into epsilon into V square upon S square Newton. Now, by observing this equation, we can say that if the potential difference and spacing between these two plates is constant, then F is proportional to V square. It is thus seen that the force of attraction is proportional to the square of the potential difference applied, so that the meter reads the square value or can be marked to read the RMS value. Electrostatic voltmeters of the attracted disc type may be connected across the high voltage circuit directly to measure up to the about 200 kV. The right hand electrode forms the high voltage plate. Here we can see this is the high voltage plate. The center portion of the left hand disc is cut away and encloses a small disc which is movable. Here we can see this is a small disk and is geared to the pointer. This is the pointer. So we can get the reading. The range of the instrument can be altered by setting the right hand disc at pre-marked distances. This way we can set the range of the instrument. The force of attraction created by the applied voltage causes the movable part to which a mirror is attached to assume a position at which a balance of forces takes place. An incident light beam will therefore be reflected toward a scale calibrated to read the applied voltage magnitude. So this way we can measure the magnitude of the applied voltage. Advantages: low loading effect. Active power losses are negligibly small. Voltage source loading is limited to the reactive power needed to charge the system capacitance. Voltages up to 600 kV can be measured. Now, disadvantage: for constant distance or spacing s, force is proportional to v square. Here we can see this f is proportional to v square. The sensitivity is small. This can be overcome by varying the gap distance d in appropriate steps. So this way we can measure the high voltages. Thank you.